गुड मॉर्निंग 10th क्लास टुडे आवर चैप्टर इज आवर चैप्टर 11 एंड द नेम इज़ द ह्यूमन आई एंड द कलरफुल वर्ल्ड एंड हियर इज द इंट्रोडक्शन गेस द नेम ऑफ द ऑर्गन इट इज़ वेरी इजी फॉर यू दिस वन इज आई लुक हियर देयर इज आईलिड देन दिस ब्लैक वन ओके ब्लैक वन इज प्यूपल देन दिस ब्लू कलर इज आयरिस समटाइम द कलर ऑफ आयरिस मे बी इट इज़ ब्राउन और ब्लैक ऑल्सो देन दिस मार्जिन इज लिम्बस एंड देन दिस वाइट पोर्शन इज क्लेरा सो दिस होल ऑर्गन इज आई ओके एंड दिस इज ह्यूमन आई सो टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज द ह्यूमन आई So here is the structure of human eye. Just look here. Here we have the front region, okay? Front portion. This front portion is known as cornea, right? And here the back one. Back one is known as sclera, okay? And total, just here we have some information about a human eye. The human eye is like a camera. And the eyeball is approximately spherical, okay, shape is spherical and then size and diameter is 2.3 centimeter, okay, approximately. Then the eye, human eye has three parts, outer part, middle part and inner part. So next we have the outer part of eye. Outer part of eye is front transparent part, cornea and then it allows light to enter inside the eye. And the back front, the back outer portion is known as it is black opaque outer layer, okay, sclera. Function is it does not allow light to escape out from eye. So just here we are transferring or we are relating that information with the diagram. So here the front portion is known as cornea. Just look here, cornea. And the back outermost, okay, this outermost back portion is known as sclera. So this cornea allows light to enter into eye and this outermost portion is sclera. Name is not mentioned here. So sclera लाइट को बाहर नहीं जाने देता है और कॉर्निया लाइट को अंदर आने देता है कॉर्निया फ्रंट पोर्शन है और स्क्लेरा आपका बैक आउटर पोर्शन है देन हम मूव करते हैं मिडिल पार्ट ऑफ आई जस्ट लुक हियर व्हाट ऑल आर प्रेजेंट आयरिस इज देयर प्यूपिल इज देयर सिलियरी मसल इज देयर क्रिस्टलाइन लेंस इज देयर कोरोइड इज देयर सो हाउ मेनी जस्ट हियर वन मिस्टेक 2.4 एंड दिस वन इज 2.5 सो 1 2 3 4 5 टोटल 5 आर देयर तो अब हम इसको उसके अंदर देखते हैं डायग्राम में वेयर आर ऑल दीज प्रेजेंट सो हियर वी हैव प्यूपल दिस स्पेस प्रेजेंट हियर इज़ नोन एज प्यूपल एंड दिस रीजन दिस डार्क मस्कुलर डायफ्राम इज़ नोन एज आयरिस क्लियर एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो कंपेयर दिस In the first diagram, just look here. This blue portion is iris and this is space. Means the space present between the iris is known as, this portion is known as pupil. And this dark muscular diaphragm, this one is made up of muscles. So dark muscular diaphragm is known as iris. Iris control the size of pupil, okay? Iris kya karta hai? Ye size jo gola gola aapko dikh raha hai, ye chota hoga ya bada hoga? Kaun decide karta hai? Iris. So iris decide the size of pupil, clear? तो अब हम बैक जाते हैं हमने टोटल 5 स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑर्गन्स देखे थे सो हियर प्यूपल आयरिस कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर हो गया आपको देन नंबर 3 इज़ अबाउट लेंस दिस लेंस एंड कैन यू गेस द शेप ऑफ द लेंस शेप ऑफ द लेंस इज इट इज़ कॉन्वेक्स clear convex shape and what is the function of convex lens converging okay it converges all the light rays and just look here it is holded by ciliary muscles dekho aap upar ki taraf bhi aapko dikhega aur niche ki taraf dikhega right वैसे ये चारों तरफ होता है so it holds ciliary muscles function is to hold lens in position lens ko position mein rakhta hai understood then ciliary muscles crystalline lens pupil iris all these are present in the front region back layer mein okay ye jo aapko circle sphere dikh raha hai iska jo second outermost kya tha sclera second layer kya ho jayega iska choroid right so all these just look here about iris dark muscular diaphragm control size of pupil clear then pupil space jo iris ke beech mein hota hai that one is pupil and here the pupil regulates and controls the amount of light entering the eye clear then ciliary muscles hold lens in position crystalline lens convex converging function choroids back second layer of eye is called choroid and it does not escape, it does not allow light to escape from eye. So this is whole about middle part of eye. Now next is inner part of eye. So look here, what all are present? Retina is there, retina, optic nerves, right? Two are there. So we are just comparing this in the diagram. So here we have our retina and optic nerves. So retina here, back layer, the innermost layer is known as retina, and here optic nerves connect eye to nerves. It connect eye. Optic word is used for eye, so it connects eye to brain. Clear? It brings messages from eye to it sends messages from eye to brain, and also from brain to eye, vice versa, right? So then we have here inner part is retina. Back inner layer of eye is called retina, and delicate membrane, light sensitive cells are there. Usi ke andar aapke paas kya hota hai, rods and cones are also present. Rods are for night vision and cones are for day vision and also for colors. Function hai, these light sensitive cells get activated upon illumination and generate electrical signals, right? And then optic nerves, nerves that connect eye to brain, and then function is to send messages, signals to brain by optic nerves. Okay, then interpretation is done by brain, and then information, so that we perceive objects as they are. Just we are doing this with reference to eye. Once again हम वापस से पढ़ते हैं actually में सारी चीज़ें function होती क्या है. So if there is any object outside, okay, outside, then what happens, light from that object enters into our eyes through this cornea, then this pupil region, then through lens. Function of lens is to converge light rays. So all the light rays are converged on retina. Clear? Then retina ke paas kya hota hai, rods and cones are present. Then they are light sensitive cells, they get activated. Clear? After activation, signals banate hain, signals are generated, and then signals through optic nerves sent to brain. Okay, and then now we see what we are observing, right? So this is whole about outer part, middle part, inner part of eye, and this one is your assignment 11.1. Draw the human eye, label the following parts. Clear? Write two differences between iris and cornea. Number third is describe the different parts of human eye with functions. And number fourth is comment upon the following: the size of pupil and function of iris when we are playing outside and we come back to room after playing. So question number 1, 2, 3, I think all these parts are clear. Question number 4 is a little bit difficult for you, and this is again, just think over it, and tomorrow I will give you answer, right? Thank you.